We are headed out on another road trip from Northern LA County to Mammoth Lakes, California. We have done this trip many, many times. We know the route. We know the superchargers. I don't think we're going to anticipate too many problems, but we shall see as we head on out for another fun road trip. We are about to head out, and this is what the nav wants us to do. It wants us to leave home with our current state of charge at 152 miles, or 57% at the moment. It wants us to stop at Inyokern 2, which is about 5 miles off the freeway. So yeah, we're not gonna do that, even though it says that we could make it on that one stop and then all the way up to Mammoth Lakes right there. We're going to do something different. We're going to go to Mojave. All right, so this is what it looks like to get to Mojave. Again, that's our state of charge, 57%, 152. And it's about an hour away, 60 miles. Got plenty of charge, even though it's going to be hot. And we're going to make it to Mojave with 32% state of charge. It's low enough to get a decent fast speed, but we're going to go ahead and charge at Mojave and then reevaluate whether we stop in Lone Pine or if we can make it all the way. I don't think we can make it. It's mostly uphill this way. We can make it back down from Mammoth Lakes down to home from, say, Bishop. But I don't think we can make it from Mojave all the way to Lone Pine or to Mammoth, which is probably why it's recommending us to stop at Inyokern. It's a long drive. It's 5 miles at least, five miles off the freeway and then 5 miles back. That's just not practical. All right, just taking a look after we left, we are due to arrive at Mojave at 32% state of charge. We are currently at 55% state of charge, another Tesla. And 148 miles on the battery. So that should be good enough to get some decent fast speeds as we head on our way up to the 295.
395.
395. Sorry, I lost 100. Doing a little first leg update. We are, well, it was 20 miles away, but now we're 19 miles away, about 20 minutes away, and we're at 25% arrival. We are currently at 94 miles and 35% state of charge. Now, you may be asking yourself, why? You're going on a road trip. Why didn't you full charge before you head out on your road trip? Well, because we knew the first stop was going to be Mojave, and we want to have faster charging. So faster charging, by the way, it happens between 0 and, say, 80% of the battery, probably 70% of the battery. So we want to live on that lower end of the battery, and we didn't want to arrive there too full, even though 25% is still kind of full, but better than if we were to arrive at, say, 60%. Mojave is home to four separate supercharger locations, and here is one of them. We've been to that one, of course. The other three are actually in the same parking lot together, but they are three separate locations, and they are definitely separated, and that's the one we're going to go to. We're going to go to the middle one because those are V3s. Mojave, by the way, if you're not familiar with the location, it's kind of a hub between Los Angeles, Bakersfield, Mammoth, and Las Vegas. So it kind of makes sense there's all these superchargers. I heard good things about this Thai cuisine place. Here is the middle one, which is
the only one.
We're gonna be the only one, so we get to choose.
No, there's one other one.
Oh, there's one other one. All right, we still, I think, have a pretty good choice of what supercharger to use. I'll show you the whole layout of this parking lot. If you haven't seen it before, it's quite unique and different. But the reason, right there ahead, you can see, is at the burger place, and there's a whole other supercharger location there. Then we're in the middle location, and then the original location is over by the supermarket. I'll show it all to you in a second. Let's get plugged in, though. All right, let's plug her in.
parked on that one.
All right, plugged in. We're gonna see what we're looking for in terms of our next supercharger location. That's the Thai restaurant that I've heard good things about. We're not really hungry right now, so we're not gonna go ahead and do that. So this is the middle location. Over there is the Stater Brothers. And over this way, you can see the original six stalls are the ones closest to us. Those are V2 150 kilowatts. Then there's some mobile chargers over there. And then there's some V3s in that location as well. So if you go to that location, make sure you get the correct ones because you don't want to charge too slow. So that's location one. We're at location two, and location three is just on the other side of that building, the Thai Cuisine. So very unique location. We've got one neighbor here, one other Tesla right now. And we used to have to fight. We used to wait in line when we started going to Mammoth. We had to wait in line for those six only. Only six stalls in all of Mammoth, or all of Mojave. All right, so what's it look like? Can we make it to Bishop or not?
I don't think we can. Is it still thinking? It's probably going to say, yeah, you got to stop at Lone Pine.
Yeah, that's what it did say. And then I did remove charging stops. Yeah, so, let's just go to Lone Pine.
How far is Lone Pine? I mean, Bishop?
It said 173.
Oh, yeah, we're not going to make that. I knew we couldn't make that. The problem is this is all uphill. Coming home, it's a whole other ballgame. We can go really long distances downhill, and it's mostly downhill. And what are we at? One?
We're getting three speeds.
Three speeds? That could be the heat. You know, it's 100-something degrees there. So, all right, well, let's charge for, how long does it say?
15
minutes, and we're out.
Quick charging update. We're about 8 minutes remaining on our trip, or to continue on our trip, I should say. We're hovered around 125 kilowatts. I believe that's based on our 100 degree temperatures right now. It actually didn't precondition at all. It's hot, it's warm. It doesn't really need to warm up. If anything, it probably need to cool the battery down. Right now we're at a -4% arrival at Lone Pine, so we're gonna go ahead and charge up probably 10 or 15% beyond that. It's hot, we've got the AC blasting, we don't know of the wind conditions, so we wanna have a little bit of a buffer, plus we're going uphill. So that's what we're looking at right now, not too much longer.
Woo, is it hot. Also, forgot to show you these. These are two kind of lonely superchargers, I guess. They are in between the middle location that I'm at and the burger area, so I'm not sure where these fall. I believe they're on the cabinets that we're using right now, but kind of interesting, there are two, and they're not even handicapped or anything like that. They're just, oh yes, they are. They are, that's what they're for. Now it makes sense. Nice big parking stalls. Very cool. And then over there are the other ones that I was telling you about over by the burger restaurant. So plenty of supercharger stalls in Mojave.
Let's take a look at Mojave and all the amount of stalls that are available in this area. So that first location that we showed you is the 13 stall. That's an interesting number, by the way, 13 stalls. Then we've got a 12 stall. Then the one we're at right now, whoops, it renavigated. Let's get that middle one going for you. There's 18 available, so that makes sense. This one's a 20 stall, and that makes sense because there are two of us here. There's the other one. And the last one is a 12 stall. So all in all, tons and tons of supercharger stalls and locations. It just popped up that we have enough charge to continue on our trip. It did so around the 15% arrival mark, I noticed. So they like to give you a buffer as well. But I'm waiting on some family members to come back from their candy run over there at Stater Brothers. So I might as well just leave it plugged in and wait. And as soon as they get back, we can unplug and go. All right, they have arrived back. We have plenty of charge. We're at 70% state of charge right now, 188 miles, so 71%. And we are due to arrive with 22% state of charge on the battery, 112 miles, and we've got 188 miles. So let's go ahead and unplug. Are you unplugging? I'll go ahead and unplug. Up here, and we're just just gonna get on the road right there. That's the beauty of Tesla superchargers, is they put them so close to the highways and stuff. Really no need to drive too far off the highway. So we're gonna go ahead and reset that. So once again, real quick, 112 miles is our distance. Let me get my hand out of there because it was focusing. 112 miles is our distance, and we have 190 for those folks that like miles. And then for you percent folks, 71% and 23% on arrival. So let's head out. Up on Coso Junction, it's a rest area, but more than that, we looked on one of our apps that we use, and there is a supercharger. I don't know what this bicyclist is doing. There's a supercharger going in right where that Chevron is. There's also Electrify America's right over there. So that gas station and Subway and whatever else is over there is gonna be a supercharger location to go along with the Electrify America's. We're gonna do a little bathroom break. I believe there's a CCS charger here that we used one time. I'm not sure if it's working still. Somebody's up there, maybe charging, great. We used our CCS adapter like when we first got it. Anyway, so Coso Junction, going to be a supercharger location, which is great. Coso Junction update, heading into Lone Pine, we are now at 14% state of charge. For a little while there, it was saying 4%, and it actually had us reroute to Inyokern for no particular reason. And then we, you know, canceled out all that and decided to, we're going to make it to Lone Pine. Don't worry about it. We'll be good. And so right now we're looking at 14% arrival, not the 20% that was promised back at Mojave, but we're kind of used to this at this point. There is the CCS. It's a 50 kilowatt, so very slow. And we've got a Subaru charging. I believe that's on the Toyota RAV4 EV platform. So it's pretty slow charging anyway, but glad to see people using it at 50 kilowatts here at Coso. So right ahead there you can see the Electrify Americas, the green and white stalls, and this is the same parking lot, or at least the same area that we're going to see a supercharger location.
That's something.
Rolling into Lone Pine. Excuse the camera, some sort of setting got changed. I need to take a look at that while we're sitting here. Wow. Lone Pine, I think for the first time in all of our trips, is completely empty. Where should we charge? This is pretty awesome. Hey, were those added on the end?
No.
I don't remember them going all the way. I thought there were two parking spots.
That was from the old Lone Pine, I think you remember.
All right, anyway, we're at Lone Pine. We're gonna go to McDonald's, get some coffee. We've got our choice of stalls, so I'm just gonna randomly pick this one. And of course, knowing our luck, it won't work. But here we are. Plugging in, I'll get you the details here in a second once we plug in. All right, so this is what we arrived at, 28 miles on the battery and 10%. It originally had us at 20% and we got as low as 4%. So 10%, I'll take it. Just a good tip is that's why you give yourself a buffer, because you just don't know. And we lost 10% because of the buffer. So I think we're plugging in. Are we plugging in? Yes, we are.
You were gonna come out.
There we go. Plugged in. See what kind of speeds we're gonna get. We're gonna try to get all the way to Mammoth. We know we can do it because we've done it in the Model 3 with a far lesser battery. So we know we can get to Mammoth with this as well. But we're gonna charge enough to do that. Full speed, folks. This is the first time on this trip. Full speed, 251 kilowatts. Which means the battery was fully optimized and it was warm and it was ready to go. And here we are. Full speed, 251, not bad. So let's go ahead and punch in Mammoth and see. You know what? It's easier probably just to find it. Where is Mammoth? I'm in the wrong direction. There we are. Mammoth Lake's right there. And this guy. And where is the supercharger? Mammoth Lake supercharger. All right, so now it's going to give us an estimate on how long it takes. Looks like 25 minutes, I think. Yeah, estimated charge time, 25 minutes. So we're going to be here for a little bit. We're going to go get some coffee.
So we arrived here and it was empty, and now we've got another guest, another Model Y just showed up. But Lone Pine, basically empty, which is unusual. This one's pretty full usually. It's about 100 miles away from Mammoth Lakes, so this is kind of your last stop. Although it's not anymore. It used to be the last stop before Mammoth. Now there are two locations in Bishop, so you got a bailout option if you want to just kind of do a splash and go, a real quick charge here, head up to Bishop, then charge again, and then head up the hill to Mammoth Lakes. But I think we're going to be able to make it all the way from Lone Pine. We're just going to charge enough. We're getting coffee anyway, so we might as well just sit and wait for it to charge.
Here comes a VW ID4 coming in hot to the Tesla superchargers. Not exactly sure what they're thinking they're doing, because I don't know if they even have an adapter for ID4, but we'll see, I guess. So just taking a look at that adapter, that is AC charging. That is not going to work. You're trying to do a... Yeah, it's red. It's not going to work. That's not... You don't have the bottom two pins there, buddy. You need a different adapter. The Volkswagen is not approved for this yet. And they're basically got an AC adapter to do DC charging. So they're going to figure it out eventually. But at the moment, probably not. Yeah, that didn't work out too well for you, buddy, did it? You can't use an AC adapter for DC charging when that's what this is designed for. So they're heading out. Not sure what they're going to do, because there's not much in this area in terms of charging CCS. I'll take a look on my own. But yeah, they basically were trying to use an adapter that is not designed for this. Yes, it has the Tesla end to it, but on the other end, it doesn't have DC, the two pins on the bottom. So off they go to no idea.
Where are they going?
Little off-road adventure for their ID4. So that was fun while we're sitting here waiting. They came in all confident too. They were coming in hot. They looked right at me. The guy walked out with his adapter like, I'm going to show these Tesla people what's what. Yeah, they're not on the list yet for... They're going to be. They're going to have the adapter. They're going to be allowed to use these, but not yet. So they didn't do their homework.
But they also didn't have the right adapter either.
No, they had an AC adapter for a DC fast charge, basically. So I knew right away it wasn't going to work as soon as I saw them plug it in. All right, we are going to unplug. Sun just came out. We should have enough. And if we don't, our bailout option is going to be Bishop, which has two locations. We're looking at a 17% arrival at the superchargers in Mammoth. We will keep an eye on that. We had a 20% estimate from Mojave to Lone Pine, ended up with 10%. So if we're seeing that that's going to be the case again, there's one right off the highway. We can stop for 5 minutes before we head up the hill at Bishop and be on our way. So here we go. We're going to leave Lone Pine. All right, we are leaving Lone Pine, Model Y, brand new Model 3, older Model 3. It was empty when we got here. And we are heading up to Mammoth. So another good charge at Lone Pine. I remember when they used to be right over here, the older ones, was it a four stall, six stall?
Six. It was really
six
small.
Stall. And I think they were Urbans.
No.
They weren't?
Two of them were Urban.
Okay, so there were Urbans.
Yeah.
And I think it was like a portable one.
Yeah.
And I think we charged on that one. So anyway, they've since upgraded to a 16 stall V3. Oh, there's that ID4. That tried to charge. So I wonder if they're trying to figure out what they're doing next. We looked up on the PlugShare app, and there is a rest stop 25 miles away that does have CCS, one stall, 50 kilowatt. So they could do that, but we are not them.
a little update. We're about to head up the hill. We're in Bishop, and the incline is coming up. We have an estimated time of arrival, or estimated percentage of arrival, of 15%. We are going to John's Pizza Works. Highly recommend it. Really good pizza. And right around dinner time, too. So that's perfect. So we are not going to stop at the supercharger that's right there, because we think 15% should be fine. And hopefully we'll have free charging at the hotel. We looked. There are 6 stalls. We'll see how it goes. If not, I will probably head to the supercharger tonight, because we don't want to leave it at 15% overnight. Just to give you an idea of the incline that we're about to hit, we're at 48% now, and the estimate is 16%, and we're only going 38 miles. So yeah, this is a pretty huge incline to go from 48 down to 16. We arrived at Mammoth with 21% state of charge. So it was pretty accurate, actually, from Lone Pine. There we are. So not a bad trip up the mountain. And we had John's Pizza Works. Delicious. Now we're off to the hotel. All right, we have arrived at our hotel, and let's see if there's any charging. Last time we were here, it was all full. I believe it's off to the right here. We shall see. Oh, I see. I think it's wide open. So we are going to charge for free, which is good, because we are at 52 miles, or under 20%, completely and wide open. This is great. Look at this.
Yep.
So there's Tesla ones, and then there's one Clipper Creek for others, unless you have an adapter. So I think we're going to just back in here. Very cool. Free juice. Don't even need a supercharge, which I think will disappoint other people in this car. All right, so when you can find a hotel with charging, it is definitely a nice benefit. And what do we got here? We got 1, 2, 3, and one Clipper Creek over there. So is that 4 total?
There's another Tesla behind the Clipper Creek.
Another Tesla behind, so 4 Tesla, 1 Clipper Creek. And this is awesome. This is very cool. So we'll be able to charge. Because take a look at this, we are pretty low right now, 52 miles, 20%. So we'll let this thing charge overnight and we're good to go.
Hey, that wraps up part one, our trip from Los Angeles County up to Mammoth Lakes, California. You can see there's a lake right here. In fact, we're going to do a supercut of all the beautiful things we're seeing as we're here in Mammoth Lakes. If you want to check that out, it's going to be after this wrap up. And that way you can enjoy that. And thank you so much for watching. Once again, another trip is in the books, and we'll catch you on the next one. Don't forget to hit the like button, the subscribe button, and what's the other one? Oh, the bell. Yes, do all of those, and we'll catch you on the next video. Thanks so much for watching. He's coming up to the left of the tree.
Right there.
Bald eagle.
Oh, yeah. Oh, my gosh. Oh, my gosh.
So cool.
Wait, Mark, do the sound.
Yeah, that's definitely a bald eagle.
Hi, bald eagle. Wait, Mark, do the sound.
Does he know he's a bald eagle?
Mark, do the sound that you hear at the zoo.
That's a bald eagle, guys.